concert that you're about to hear is a product of a very exciting and multi-layered collaboration between composers from the Royal Conservatoire, researchers from many different schools of the University of St Andrews, and performers from both institutions. You'll see alongside each other during the course of the six pieces we're about to hear. All of the composers are going to say a few words about their pieces, so I'd like to hand over to David Ford, who is the first composer we're going to hear from. Thank you very much.
I work with, for this week, I work with Clara Brasseur, who is a fantastic astronomist from St. Andrews. And her research was about a magnetic field of a star. It's called, this particular star called AB Door A. But I was like, in the early stage of composing, like, how do I make this research into music? I was thinking. And then I decided not to write about a magnetic field
today's topic is ocean science and climate, obviously. So today's piece is about the journey that I want to take you all on. It's a perspective of Mother Earth as she gets back into Ice Age. So this is a journey of how due to dissolving carbon dioxide in the ocean, she gets back into Ice Age. So there are three small sections in this piece, and the first one is Earth is all happy and sunny and warm, and it's going around the sun, and slowly it's, it goes distant from the sun and it feels cold. The second one is what's happening in the deep ocean, and the organic matter and the carbon dioxide and activity that's there, and that's slowly coming to a freeze. And the third section is the actual Ice Age. So the piece name is Sheetala. It means goddess of ice or goddess of cool. So hope you enjoy. Thank you.
your ampules filled with what she describes as saintly effluent, I'll let you think about what that might mean, or dust from tombs which desperate pilgrims would lick or scrape off, desperate for some sort of visceral connection to God through these objects. So the piece that I've written, The Shrinekeeper's Shop, is sort of an imaginary sales pitch from a shrinekeeper trying to flog these sorts of objects to desperate pilgrims. And there were a couple of things that struck me about Molly and her work when I was writing it, which helped me put it together. One of them is her writing and her voice, which is amazing. And the other is her joy at collecting these really weird objects. So in constructing it, we went to a bit of a collecting mission of our own, and almost everything that you hear is constructed from transcriptions of Molly and I singing along to Latin medieval body parts. So that's how that got put together. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.